This camera just goes for 30 minutes at a time. And I gotta restart it. Piece of shit. Probably so. This is a 32 gigabyte card, which should be alright.
Every secret thing, whether it be good or bad. But they, you know, I mean, of course you guys, people are told that they're not under the law of them, you know? They don't have to follow the law. So they, their dirty-ass filter, they filter in what's out that was, you know, what they think is right and what's wrong. So they continue to do all kind of wonderful things. They continue to do all kind of wonderful things.
You're like, no, baby, you can eat whatever you want. It's all about what's in your heart.
It's not the truth.
It's not what goes in you, but what comes out you.
Right. That's a TV show. And that's what was sad, man. That's what was sad thing that these people don't have the common sense of what's right and what's wrong. So they teach their children the same fucking shit.
Well, what do you think the little children that was up here was being taught? See how dirty they was?
Right.
They didn't have socks or shoes, was all fucked up.
They were with their mom.
They down here downtown and they just run around downtown all by themselves. You don't tell me that's not crazy? But these women, and she probably getting child support for them too. She getting child support for them, EBT, everything. And her kids look raggedy as hell. I bet she was wearing some new shit though. You know what I'm saying? I bet she had that new weed. You know what I'm saying? She got that fucking, those nice nail. I bet she got a nice phone. She probably got a pocket full of weed, pills. She got some loud too. She got that good shit. You know she ain't smoking no dirt. She, you know what I'm saying? She got all the good shit while her kids are fucking starving. Running around looking homeless. She got boogers all up, smeared all over her face. These bitches ain't shit, man. Report to the Lord, you know what I'm saying? Especially you see, after you die, you got to report to the Lord. I mean, you better not have a bad report. The Lord's gonna ask you, you know what I'm saying, you've been down there doing my work. You better be doing the work of the Lord. You got your bullshit, wasting your time. Actually, that movie's fucking pretty good. Actually, if you think about it. You know, Patrick Swayze is gay.
That's me. Jacob. Jeremiah 11 and 10. They are turned back to the iniquities of their forefathers, which refused to hear my word. And they went after the gods to serve them, the house of Israel and the house of Judah, that broke the covenant which I made with their fathers. Therefore, thus says the Lord, behold, I will bring evil upon them, which they shall not be able to escape. And though they shall cry unto me, I will not hearken unto them. And that's going to be a hell of a problem, too.
Yeah, that's going to be, because you hear them, bro. Just like, you hear these bitches how proud they are. Going back to that, those riots that broke out in Milwaukee. Bitches was talking shit like, get those motherfuckers, get them, get them, get them. You know what I mean? Talking all that shit. All of a sudden, one gunshot got fired anyway, and now they're screaming, begging for praying to them.
Jesus! Oh my God!
Jesus!
Oh my God!
Yeah, some of this was playing famous too.
Let's start with one. Try to gonna tell me you want to put these women in the infantry unit instead of the war? Oh, you really do. You have five.
That's beautiful, man. That's what I want to see. You know?
Bro, yeah, fucking maybe Jake gets some pussy out there while he's doing it.
Yep. Hopefully some reporter with a camera catch some bitches getting blown the fuck up. Yeah. That's what I want to see.
Man. They gonna be out there while they in the field have a war. They out there fighting their so-called enemy. Jake gonna be getting herpes all over himself, breaking out. They get burned up in the wilderness, you know what I mean?
Jake gonna care
about
some
of
the
pictures
all the time.
Oh,
that shit. That's where that's where Sintro started at. They started giving it to the
military. Oh, they gave some shit all right.
Yeah. I mean, I think so. Yes.
Beautiful. It's like crazy.
Is that the one where there's no more children?
Yeah.
It's got a dude from 300 in it. There's a place.
That bitch. This is crazy. Crazy bitch.
Yeah, I've seen it.
Most likely set these bitches up. You set them up a little bit. Set them up. Sweet YouTube. You know how we watching footage from Ukraine and Syria on the internet? You see some of that? You see some of that? Like what you can run and fuck up?
Oh, that'd be fun.
Yeah, that's what we do. In her mind, that's her way of getting making. You know, that's just an example. Most like the sentence, man. You know how this bitch trusts her. Man, walk with her.
I got scripted to the back of what you said. That's kind of lovely. Because you said that. So you say women is going to get blown up? You wicked. I'm going to read out the New Testament. Revelation 21 and 6. Man, actually, I'm going to start even back up here. Now I'm just start reading. Revelation 21 and 6. And he said unto me, it is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. And we spoke on that when we first started talking today about that water. A lot of these dudes out here, they walk around in the desert with no water, you know what I mean? They can't find the oasis. All they found was a mirage. So that water is good too, bro. That's what keep you hydrated. Drinking it. Say, he that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. Hey, that proves who the sons of God are too. People talking about the Nephilim, the sons of God, that was fallen angels. No, we're the sons of God. That's what it says right here. We're the sons of God. Yeah, the Israelites, the nation of Israel, that's the sons of the Most High.
That's right.
That's the sons of God that you read about in Genesis, the 6th chapter. That was called the Nephilim, or giants. That's the Israelites. And that's because the Lord said he flooded the earth. Why did the Lord flood the earth? Before it said that, if you read Genesis 6, it said the wickedness of the man have exceeded. You should get that. Because this goes in with the first death, with the flood. So the second death is going to be fire, right? And it's going to be for the same reason that he flooded the earth. Ain't no new thing under the sun. Where's that Genesis 6 on the set, the wickedness of man, he destroyed the earth with the wickedness of man. I'll find it. You know, he didn't say exactly. He said the wickedness had a... Yeah, start a 4.
Wickedness has exceeded. Is that what it's
called? Yeah.
Genesis 6 and 4.
There I was trying to hear what you're saying.
Oh, yeah, I couldn't even get it out right. There were giants in the earth in those days.
Yeah, that's that word giant. You look it up in Hebrew, it says so-called Nephilim. Go ahead. That's talking about us, okay? We're the fallen ones.
If you see our people falling, then...
Okay. It's like when people say that you was once a hot shot, but you like, man, you don't tell the fuck off. You know, when you see somebody that came out with 5 good albums, and all the other albums are horrible, like, man, you fell the fuck off. You know what I mean? That's what falling. Our people fallen from a high state, because we used to be a righteous people. You know what I'm saying? Now we turn into the wickedness of filth. Go ahead, read that.
When the sons of God came into the children of men, the daughters of men, and they bare children to them.
Hey, the daughters of men, that's talking about these other nations. Where's the sons of God? We're not the sons of man, even though we're sons of actual men, but we were called the sons of God, the sons of the Most High. Go ahead, the sons of the living power. Go ahead.
They became mighty men, which were of old men of renown.
Yeah, who was the men of old renown? That was us. That was our people. Go ahead.
God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth.
And it said, oh, see, this proves this isn't talking about fallen angels being wicked in the earth. Because it's redead.
That every imagination of the thoughts of his heart were only evil continually.
But read that again from the top of that part. That
Genesis 6 and 4, 5. And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth.
So wickedness of man was great in the earth. Didn't it say the wickedness of fallen angels, the wickedness of Lucifer and all this bugged out shit? Didn't it say that? So the wickedness of man, read that. Yeah.
God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually.
Isn't that what you see out here today? The imagination, the thoughts of everybody's heart is just evil continually. Continually. It just gets worse. You know what I mean? It's a perpetual wickedness. Go ahead.
And it repented the power that he made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. I was said, I would destroy man whom I have created from the face of the earth.
Yeah, so he destroyed man. I mean, that was the point right there. But that's why the Lord destroyed the earth, because men, they was wicked as hell. They was greedy. You gonna imagine what kind of shit they was doing back in those days. And that was back when people used to live to be damn near 1,000 years old. People used to live to be 900 years old. What kind of wickedness could you achieve in 800 years?
Whole lot, man. Even on top of people.
You can't even imagine. That's unimaginable wickedness.
Unimaginable.
How would you say that shit? You can't imagine it. It's impossible.
We can probably put it in words.
Yeah, you can.
But they can't comprehend it.
800 years?
They think we were still walking around with sticks and rocks.
Well, that's back during the Ice Age. When we was hunting fucking woolly mammoths. All this bullshit. And so let me link this up with that. Revelation 21:7. He that overcometh shall inherit all things. And I will be his God, and he shall be my son. Right? Because we're the sons of God. Even the word Israel itself means what? He is a prince of God, or a prince of the power. Right? Yasharallah. Yah means he, Shar means prince, and Allah means God. Right? And what is a prince? Is a prince not the son of a king?
That's right.
Yep, joint heirs. Israel is the Lord's inheritance. It says, but the fearful and the unbelieving and the abominable and the murderers and whoremongers. Whoremongers, you don't even know what goes under the whoremongers category.
You're right.
Revelation 21:8. But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. So I guess the Lord is wicked and evil though, right? Because he said he's going to burn all these people up with fire. But if we say it, then, you know, people have a problem. The Lord is brutal, man. That's what's coming. The Lord is brutal, man. He ain't fucking around. When the Lord comes back, it's going to be pure brutality. That's like Exodus 15 said. After Moses, through the power, you know, with the Most High, led the Israelites through the Exodus. After the Exodus, what did the people say? Let me get that real quick. Just real quick. They seen the power of the Most High. And what did they say after he fucked up the Egyptians? Yeah. Let me get that real quick. Exodus 15. Oh, watch this. This is the kind of song your people sang and rejoicing. Look, it says Exodus 15:1. Then sang Moses and the children of Israel this song unto Yahweh, and spake, saying, I will sing unto Yahweh, for he hath triumphed gloriously, the horse and his rider he thrown into the sea. So our people, we rejoice. Because remember, earlier you said that you pray, you know, these bitches get fucked up or whatever. But we pray that the Lord destroys our enemies. You know what I mean? And then we rejoice with psalms, we sing hymns to celebrate the Lord destroying our enemies. There's nothing wicked about that. It says, I will sing unto Yahweh, for he hath triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider hath he thrown into the sea. Yahweh is my strength and song, and he has become my salvation. He is my God, and I will prepare him a habitation, my father's God, and will exalt him. Exodus 15:3, it says, the Lord is a man of war, the Lord is his name. But when you see the Lord in all capital letters, make sure that's still going. When you see the Lord in all capital letters in the Bible, if you didn't know, when you look that up in the original Hebrew, the word Yahweh is written, and that's the name of the Most High. Okay, so every time you see in the Bible where it says the Lord in all caps, that's the Lord's name. So this actually does not say the Lord is a man of war, the Lord is his name. It really don't say that. The way you really read it is, it says Yahweh is a man of war, Yahweh is his name. Okay, Pharaoh's chariots and his host hath he cast into the sea. Look, his chosen captains are also drowned in the Red Sea. The depths have covered them. They sank to the bottom like a stone.
And they got all kind of proof that that happened
too. Yeah, they found all the chariots, wheels, and all that.
We were sticking up with cranks and clank.
I want to keep reading this real quick. But right here, look. But that right hand, O Yahweh, has become glorious in power. Thy right hand, O Yahweh, has dashed in pieces the enemy. And in the greatness of thine excellency, thou hast overthrown them that rose up against thee. Thou sendest forth thy wrath, which consumed them as stubble. And with the blast of thy nostrils, the waters were gathered together. The flood stood upright as a heap, and the depths were congealed in the heart of the sea. I mean, that's what we can read it all day, but you can see that's the gloriousness of the Lord, bro. Yep. What did that say right there? It said, I gotta read this again. It said, in the greatness of thine excellency, thou hast overthrown them that rose up against thee.
Check out. India. I know which one of them. I'm India.
India. Again, it said, but look what it says. In the greatness of thine excellency, thou hast overthrown them that rose up against thee.
We're in that spirit too.
That is
talking about the enemy.
Yeah. And the Lord is going to destroy his enemy.
That's the spirit too.
America's a proud nation.
That's exactly what I'm saying. Let me see this, man?
Oh, yeah.
This is Ecclesiastes 25:7. There be nothing, there be nine things which I have judged in my heart to my habit, and the tenth I will love her and tongue. A man that hath joy of his children, and he that liveth to see the fall of his enemy.
Right, exactly. That's what Moses cried for. He prayed to the Most High that he delivered the Israelites out of the hand of the Egyptians, and to destroy the Egyptians, destroy the Pharaoh. That's what we pray, that the Lord destroys this entire country. You know what I'm saying? And he is going to destroy it.
Just as promised.
It's going to be laid waste from the east coast to the west coast. It's going to be a lake of fire. That's the prophecy of the future of America. Fire.
Psalm 7 and 9. Oh, that the wickedness of the wicked come to an end, and establish the just, for the righteous God tries the hearts of men.
Yeah, that's a good scripture, man. Right, because the Lord, he tries our hearts out here, because we living in this wickedness, so we tempted with all this wickedness every day. You know what I mean? It's hard to live. It's hard for a righteous man to live out here. It's stressful. It's fucking torture.
This is Micah 7 and 8. Rejoice not against me, O my enemy. When I fall, I shall arise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be the light unto me. I will bear the indignation of the Lord.
Because really, we in darkness out here. I mean, we got the light, you know what I'm saying? But we live in here. This is the valley of the shadow of death. There's that shadow of death casting out here. You know what I'm saying? But you got to have that light to be able to make it out here. You walk through this dark ass world. I got a precept for that.
I will bear the indignation of the Lord, because I have sinned against him, until he please my call and execute judgment for me. He will bring me forth to the light, and I shall behold the light. Then she that is my enemy shall see it, and shame shall cover her and say unto me, where is the Lord thy God? My eyes shall behold her now, shall she be trodden down as the eyes.
Gonna get done like Jezebel. Yeah, a lot of these hoes, they gonna get trotted down in the mire. They're out of order. All of our people are all out of order. They are just doing whatever the hell they want, just being wicked as hell. Nah, bro, can't even speak. You gotta have an assistant.
That thy walls are to be built, and in that day shall the decree be far removed. In that day also he shall come even to thee from Assyria, and from the fortified city, and from the fortress even to the river, and from the sea to sea, from mountain to mountain. Notwithstanding the land shall be desolate because of them that dwell there, for the fruit of their goings.
Yeah, they're going to be laid desolate for the fruit of their goings. What's the fruit of these people doing? The adultery. What's the punishment for adultery in the Bible? Death.
Yeah.
And that's like the main crime out here. Lying and adultery.
I see that video with you in front of Shabbat. It was adultery. And it took off running. What's his name? How you say it? Shabbat. Took off running. Dude was like, where you going, Shabbat? Where you going?
Spock proud, man. You can only hold it, you can only hide your shit for so long. Yeah, because they'll be thinking, oh, I'm getting away with it, so they'll keep doing it and doing it. They think I ain't never get caught. The bot got that Peraza spirit. Don't let him and Peraza get that same spirit. He's trying to say, yeah, I bet he's Peraza teaching the mark of the beast is sin. How the hell is the mark of the beast going to be sin and breaking the commandments like the bot said? when the scriptures say that the Lord came to forgive us of our sins. But the scriptures say if you take the mark of the beast, you can't be forgiven for that. It's not talking about sin whatsoever. We're talking about taking that mark, microchip. The scripture said all things can be forgiven except for the blasphemy of the Holy Spirit. The mark of the beast is totally something different. So pretty much when the mark of the beast is you showing your allegiance to the devil. Pretty much what it is. People were like, wow, what happened if somebody had them forcibly implanted and they didn't know about it? And they was innocent. Because the box said, what about the people in prison who was innocent and had it? I'm like, they in prison. I'm sorry, most people in the prison are pieces of shit. They won't be there. What's the scripture in Romans 13 tell you that? You ain't seen us getting locked up. We ain't out here doing no dumbass shit. If you don't do dumbass shit, chances are you ain't gonna get locked up. Most people get locked up for selling drugs, wilding out, beating the shit out of people, starting problems. They don't like act like everybody locked up. We get close. It looked like the zombie apocalypse out this motherfucker. For real.
That's scary.
This is a real life Walking Dead out here, bro. But yeah, man, that shit bullshit come back on TV soon, though.
I know the fear of Walking Dead is starting.
Yeah. It did start getting garbage. I ain't really watched TV in like a year. Shit, you ain't gotta watch it. I guess you should come out here and see out here.
I put the camera, it's cool.
It's crazy. We should really make our own a zombie documentary. Get all the fucked up, crazy people on camera. And build up a database and go home. And then we'll edit it all together. I've been wanting to do mini videos like that. Do a video on fast history. Just document every obese bitch you see. Not just every bitch, just obese bitch. Oh. Yeah, right. Well, you can buy a couple extra memory cards. I gotta get a new hard drive. But yeah, we'll get it together. I seen one in Kroger today drive one of the little carts because he's too fat. They shouldn't even have those carts in those stores, man. They got... These dumbass holes in these stores, they accommodate to the needs of these fucking people. Say, fuck these people. And then the fat people, they get offended when they get charged for two airline tickets. Like, you should have to pay for two. Taking up two seats. They act like it was the airliner's fault.
I remember doing the plane they charged.
I wouldn't even let his ass on the plane. That looked like a flight risk.